went up to attack Jerusalem, but they were not able to conquer it. When word came to the house of David that Aaron was encamped in Ephraim, the heart of the king and the heart of the people trembled, as the trees of the forest tremble in the wind. Then the Lord said to Isaiah, "Go out to meet Ahaz, you and your son Sheer-Jashub, at the end of the conduit of the upper pool, on the highway of the fuller's field, and say to him, 'Take care you remain tranquil and do not fear. Let not your courage fail before these two stumps of smoldering brands, the blazing anger of Rezin and the Arameans, and the hand of the son of Remaliah. Because of the mischief that Aram, Ephraim, and the son of Remaliah plots against you, saying, "Let us go up and tear Judah asunder, make it our own by force, and appoint the son of Tabeel king there." Thus says the Lord, "This shall not stand, it shall not be. Damascus is the capital of Aram, and Rezin is the head of Damascus. Samaria is the capital of Ephraim, and Remaliah's son, the head of Samaria. But within 60 years and 5, Ephraim shall be crushed, no longer a nation. Unless your faith is firm, you shall not be firm." The word of the Lord. God upholds his city forever. Great is the Lord and holy to be praised. In the city of our God, his holy mountain, fairest of heights, is the joy of all the earth.
God
upholds his city forever. Mount Zion, the recesses of the north, is the city of the great king. God is with her castles. Renowned is he as a stronghold.
God upholds his city forever.
For lo, the kings assemble, they come on together. They also see and at once are stunned, terrified, routed.
God holds his city forever.
Quaking seizes them there, anguished like a woman's in labor, as though a wind from the east were shattering ships of Tarshish.
God holds his city forever.
Alleluia,
alleluia.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Alleluia,
alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus began to reproach the towns where most of his mighty deeds had been done, since they had not repented. Woe to you, Chorazin! Woe to you, Bethsaida! For if the mighty deeds done in your midst had been done in Tyre and Sidon, they would long ago have repented in sackcloth and ashes. But I tell you, it will be more tolerable for Tyre and Sidon on that day of judgment than for you. And as for you, Capernaum, will you be exalted to heaven? You will go down to the netherworld. For if the mighty deeds done in your midst had been done in Sodom, it would have remained until this day. But I tell you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom on the day of judgment than for you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Whenever we look at a newborn child or a child taking his first steps, that's quite fun, it's quite humorous. They're a little unstable. They're trying to gain whether or not their legs, that they're starting to understand how to control, will actually hold them up, will actually allow them to stand firm. In our own Christian lives, we often are like newborns taking first steps, not because we are older and more mature, but because Christ is constantly pouring out to us new life. Each day, we kind of take a new step in our faith, asking, is the Lord still truly going to be there? Very much like a toddler taking his first steps, our spiritual lives can become just like that, where we ask the Lord, do I really trust you? Will you really uphold me in this next moment, this next step of faith? In today's first reading, Isaiah is prompted to go against one of the greatest kings that was Isaiah is told not to tremble, but to stand firm, trusting in the Lord. He's not to go with the currents of the time, but to listen and trust in the Word of God and the Word of God alone. The saint we celebrate today manifests this beautiful, firm faith in a wonderful way. Born into a Native American tribe, she was forced with much pressure to maintain just the status quo, to not go against anything that she hadn't known yet, to not adopt Christianity. And yet she knew with firmness of faith that truly Christ was to be the one she betrothed herself to. And going against what her people wanted, she decided to become a Christian and had a great influence not only within her own community, but even to our church today. By her own vocations, Pope Benedict wrote, she found the courage to persevere in her life of holiness. And so too for us, taking the example of Isaiah and Saint Kateri, may we continuously grow firmer in our own faith, so that we too, by the courage of being called to be a saint, may take those next steps and walk with conviction, knowing that Christ truly is one we can depend on, one we truly can follow. Standing, we bring our prayers and petitions to God, our Heavenly Father. We pray for Pope Francis and for Wilton, our bishop, and for all those who are entrusted with shepherding Christ's church, that they, persevering through these times, may always seek to bring the gospel to all peoples. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray also for all those in authority, that they may seek the common good of those entrusted to them and of the whole world. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for all those who have distanced themselves from the church, that listening to the voice of the Good Shepherd, they may return to the fold. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for all those who are sick and suffering, especially those in our own families, that they may experience the healing hand of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for all those who have died, that through the mercy of God they rest in peace. Let us pray to the Lord. Good and gracious Father, you call us your children to walk with you in faith. Hear and answer us as we make our prayer. We make our prayer confidently in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, and the
as we proclaim your wonders, O Lord, and the Virgin, blessed Kateri, we humbly implore your majesty that as her merits are pleasing to you, so too our dutiful service may find favor in your sight, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.